Hi, beautiful friends. It's so wonderful to connect with you. I'm going to be sharing some sacred frequencies. It has been a while, and I'm so beyond excited to share these for connecting with sacred sites around the world. We go every year to Mount Shasta. We're going to be there, and this is one of the sacred sites. So it's an amazing vortex of energy. Just being there is so uplifting, so enlightening. And especially for people like you and I that are healers, that are always giving to other people, we sometimes need a little bit of time for ourselves. So this is how I see this retreat. And we will be there in Mount Shasta Divine Starlight. We will be there for 3 days, and it's just life-changing. It's like almost going to a parallel reality where we are all healers, we have nature all surrounding us, we have a chef bringing us food. It is out of this world. Let's start connecting with that sacred land that can help us so much. When I go, for example, to Spain, I teach twice a year there, and it is a little bit different than when I teach here in Los Angeles, because here in Los Angeles, I can see the mountains, the sky is always really widely available because we have like lower houses. But when I'm in Spain, in Madrid especially, which is my place, it's my hometown, I feel that in order to see the sky, sometimes I have to look up, and there are no mountains that I can see around the city. And sometimes when I sing shamanic songs, it is kind of difficult to connect with Mother Earth. It is like, it is less present. So in places like Mount Shasta, like different sacred lands, we have the opportunity to really be one with nature, something that has been stripped away from the cities, and we need to bring it back. The story that comes to mind is that in our backyard, my husband and I had all grass. So it was beautiful, all green, but we had to water it and cut it. So it was a lot of maintenance. So finally, we felt, you know, we are in a drought. We live in a semi-desert, so why not just take off all the grass and live in tune with where we live? We live in a semi-desert, so let's honor that and let's see how it feels to have plants that are natural to this environment. So we started doing that. We took off the grass, which was sad. I was really attached to it. But then we started planting sages and lavender and rosemary and all these plants that are natural to this area. Well, the experience was fascinating. Everything started growing on its own. We didn't have to water it. And also the birds started coming much more because they love to be on the dirt. And now we had spots with dirt and spots with plants, so they ate insects in the plants and then they bathed in the dirt. So they were having a blast. And I was having a blast, and I still do when I look through the window, which is right there, and I see them playing and all the squirrels. So thanks to live in harmony with our environment, we really brought that gift back to us. We are part of nature, so this is part of what I want for all of you to remember. Just remember, you are nature. It's not that we are connecting with nature, it's that you are nature. So anytime that we go to one of these sacred lands, sacred sites, we have the opportunity to fully be immersed in that energy and remember who we truly are at our core. So in these sacred frequencies, I invite you to connect with the sacred site that is going to help you with that sacred land. And there are many sacred lands. We go to Mount Shasta once a year, but there is also Joshua Tree, and there is many other lands that you could connect with. So just think of the one that resonates with you, and we're going to go into the sacred frequencies.